Today, the day that I'm filming this, it's his birthday. And obviously, times where I would be cooking in this kitchen and he would come from behind me and just hug. Today we are going to be doing a very special video dedicated to my father, which a lot of you guys met. What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today, the day that I'm filming this, it's his birthday, August 2nd, my Leo man. I wanted to remember him by cooking. I'm about to cry. I've had a phenomenal day, and these are tears of joy because obviously I am remembering him. And one thing that he loved the most was my mom's cooking and also my cooking and food overall, especially fish. So where we come from in Sinaloa, we used to fish when we were little, and he used to fish a lot. He used to be in tournaments and whatnot, and every time he would bring fish to the house, we either have fish soup, which I hated. That is not what I'm doing because I'm planning to eat. We used to have pescado zarandeado. We used to have marlin. We used to have all kinds of fish in the house, in the freezer. Almost every other weekend, every weekend, every other day, like, we had a lot of seafood in the house. If you're from Sinaloa, you know what I'm talking about because you're from the coast, baby. The point is that I wanted to celebrate his birthday in honor of him, of course. Here I go again, trying to cry. And my mom is on her way because we are going to be making pescado zarandeado together. I figured that this could be a gift for him, and it could also be quality time with my mom because I love to cook with her. I love to learn from her, especially her delicious food that she is so good at. So this video is not necessarily a recipe, but it's just her and I hanging out, cooking, and, you know, just really being grateful for having her and for the time that we get to spend together, and then of course also celebrating my dad. So she is on her way. When she comes, we'll, you know, get things started. It's so crazy for me to even experience my own journey and my own self because I started washing the dishes before my mom comes, and I'm obviously reminiscing and I'm obviously thinking of my dad. And, you know, like I said, it's been a phenomenal day. Like, even today, ever since my dad passed, he seems to be connecting with me through colibris. And I always forget what you call those in English. And these are actually stickers that I made when he had passed. And I ended up making merch that says follow your bliss. And this sticker said follow your bliss and be present. And they actually have his birthday right here. And initially I had made them, you know, to like gift them to people and just as a thank you for them ordering my merch. And then when that happened, I wasn't ready to share that just yet, and so I didn't. But I'm thinking about all of this right now. It feels like forever that I don't have a conversation with him. It feels like forever that I don't see him. It feels like forever that I don't get to, you know, spend time with him. But every single time there's been a change or a shift in my life, un colibrí se me aparece siempre. And today I was in the drive-thru, I was in the coffee bean drive-thru, and all of a sudden I see one going from flower to flower. And in that moment, I wasn't even thinking of my dad's birthday, but I saw the colibrí and I was like, oh, my dad, right? And then I put two and two together later on, and I was just like, wow, like, no matter where I go and no matter what I do, like, this seems to be the sign that you are always with me. And I mean, I've been wearing him, you know, for those of you guys that were not part of my life a little bit ago on TikTok where I talked about this. This is a urn where inside of it, there's actually some of his ashes in here. And I don't always wear it, but for the past like 2-3 weeks, I've just been wearing it because I'm in such huge transition in my life, where I'm moving out of state, where I'm moving from the house where he was at, where he came to surprise me a couple of times, where I housed him, you know, while he was sick, and I was here making so many memories with him in this house. Obviously, this is not my house, so, you know, it was due time for me to move, but it's really, really cool. Like the other day, I was even disposing of alcohol, and these are actually bottles that he had brought of whiskey from Tennessee from one of the times that he was out there working. And I just decided, because I got the idea from someone that actually gifted me this, or gifted Sam and I these, I got the idea that I was gonna make some, but with the bottles that he gave me, so that, you know, I can keep them in my new home. And like, obviously that's another part that I can take with me that, you know, belong to him, or, you know, just to remember him. It's beautiful. I'm excited because, you know, like, I do feel emotional, but not like in a really sad way. But more than anything, like, it's just reminiscing, you know, and just nostalgic, and obviously times where I would be cooking in this kitchen and he would come from behind me and just hug me, or like just be him, you know, which sometimes he was a little annoying, but he was still him, and I still very much loved him for who he was. Man, I'm not trying to be crying when the time my mom comes, because I know I'm gonna see her and I'm just gonna fall in her arms. Oh, but I am excited to be doing this, so I can't wait till my mom gets here and we start cooking. I kind of prepped the kitchen and cleaned up, because on this side I have the little store going on that I'm going to be having tomorrow when you guys are going to come and visit and do a little bit of shopping, so I'm excited for that. I cannot wait till mom gets here and we start doing that. Thank you guys so much for always being here and for always being so supportive and, you know, showing love in so many ways. I feel like for a long time I wasn't able to speak on what happened with him because it hurt me so much, and grieving is one of those things that you experience always, you know. Like, I've talked to people and it's been 15 years, and all of a sudden sometimes they get a burst of emotions and they just start crying and want whoever their person that they lost back, you know. So if you're going through that, I send you so much light and so many hugs, because trust me, I know what you're feeling. And there's ups and there's downs, and there's times when you feel great and there's times when you feel really, really down, and sometimes you can't explain it, but you know, that's part of what it is, and unfortunately is what life is in this moment. So for now, I send you guys a lot of light, a lot of hugs, and I hope that this video, whatever it turns into, that it brings you a little bit of happiness and joy, because I know that it's going to bring me so much joy while I'm filming it, while I'm spending time with my mom, while we're cooking, while we're reminiscing, you know, on my dad and who he was. And also while I'm editing this, I'm sure I'm just, I'm going to be having fun. So thank you so much for
being here. Hey guys, mom is here.
Hello. Happy birthday to my dad.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. So yes, we're here. We are going to cook now.
Bien padre, ¿cómo encontraste esta? Oh, ¿cómo encontraste este pescado? Sabes que no tengo servilleta, pues no sé por qué no te dije. No he comprado. Garlic.
Pero es que lleva...
Qué ríe. Una cucharada y todo.
No, pero es que se fue porque estaba...
Time to mix.
Nada más lleva un poquito más de sal.
No, ok.
Pero ahí está.
Sí. Un día vas a abrir un restaurante.
Sí.
Me metí a TikTok y según hay un restaurante que vende pescado zarandeado y lo they braise en el carbón. Sí. Que según es estilo Sinaloa.
Ah,
La parte, ponlo ahí. La parte del pescado, es muy importante saber cuál es la parte de abajo y la parte de arriba. Esta es la parte de abajo donde lo vas a voltear, porque por eso no lleva sal, sino que le pones salsa china. Y ahora le vas a poner la salsa que preparamos. No te preocupes con esto. Con la misma cuchara nos va a sobrar sal.
O sea que esta parte
es la parte de arriba del pescado. Haz de cuenta cuando lo filetean, esta es la parte que donde tenía la de abajo, donde tenía el cuero del pescado. Esto es súper rápido y súper sencillo.
Esta le encantaba a mi papá. Y a mí también.
Con la pescada, cocinaba mucho pescado.
That's what I was telling them.
Siempre teníamos pescado en casa.
Y hacías caldo de pescado.
El otro día se me antojó. Vi un huachinango súper rico, se veía y dije, ay, pero está muy grande. Lo venden entero y dije, ay, ¿es para mí sola?
Pero sí, I don't like...
Caldo de pescado
is not good for me.
Listo, pues ya lo tienes así. Y si este lo horno a 350, lo vas a poner media hora adentro.
Las ollas después, right?
Sí. Mientras que se cocina, la media hora del pescado.
¿Le ponemos tiempo?
Sí, media hora. Media hora. Entonces, mientras que se cocina, vas a partir la cebolla blanca en rodajas.
¿Es
un
filet?
Ajá.
¿Lo venden así de grande?
Ya. Tú lo puedes comprar así.
Yo pensaba que todo
es lenguado.
Con que es una cucaracha. ¿Y cuánto? ¿10?
Unos 10 minutos.
Además, como ahí donde estaba ella, está la puerta a la cochera y está el cuarto aquí que sí,
ya.
Ya,
ya, ya está.
Literal ayer.
Qué bueno.
Me llevan a la Marshalls. Yo aquí vendiendo. Pero vamos a Marshalls, you guys. We're gonna eat after. Once we come back, vamos a caminar un ratito. Hacer ejercicio.
Para hacer hambre.
Para hacer hambre. All right, we made it to Marshalls. It's the fact que mira qué bonito el sunset.
Where?
Look.
Oh, yeah.
Como me traes. Oh, that's so cute. See, this is why I'm not supposed to be coming here because...
Why?
I'm moving. I'm not supposed to be buying anything right now. ¿Qué buscas, mom? ¿Qué buscas? A white shirt for Manny's party.
Esta parte
es crema.
I know.
You guys, I'm literally following my mom like row by row, and this is normally what I used to do when I was little. Like, I'd be like, I hate coming to these stores. But. Mande. Literal, she'd be like, stay here with me, stay here with me, stay next to me. No te quedes atrás. So we're shopping for tomorrow's for Manny's birthday party. Ay, sí, ahí te veo con ese vestido. No compramos nada, you guys.
No, vamos a dar la vuelta.
Sí, nada más quería salir de la casa, me hubieras dicho. Ay, ay, ay. Hubiéramos sido por... Ay, no. No tengo pastel en la casa.
¿Pastel?
Ya. Yeah.
¿Qué pastel?
Ahorita lo vamos a ver.
Ay, sale pues.
Hay de diferentes. Hay to choose.
Ay, to choose.
Es que compré mini cakes.
¿Mini cakes?
Ya. Yeah.
El otro día el Manny me da tanta risa.
Why?
Porque llegué del trabajo y vi un montón de cosas que le compró al perro en la mesa, dejó todo. Y vi de los crumble cookies, hay una cajita así.
y la abrí y vi galletas así, tres galletas chiquitas. Y dije, oh my God, ya hacen galletas para los perros. Ay, qué padre, que no sé qué. Y tenía antojo de pan y pues no, ni por aquí. Y al otro día, que entro al cuarto del perro en la noche que llegué, y estaba la cajita con una sola galleta. Dije, ay, hijo, ¿por qué le diste tanta galleta al perro y ya se comió dos? Me dice, ¿cuál, mamá? Y le digo, las scramble cookies esas que... No, y soltó la risa el marido. No, dice, esas eran mías. Si hubiera sabido, me hubiera comido una.
That's right.
Yo pensé que eran del perro, literal.
Ahora sí, dice, y se sienta. Ahora sí, hay que calentar la tortilla, mona. No. Ay, no. Ah. A ver. ¿Qué hice con el sorpe?
¿Qué pido este?
¿Qué?
Está bonito, digo. ¿Cómo se llama? Novecita.
Sí, es perfecto. Lo compro con una serie. Lo compro con él. Me digo que tengo frío.
Mira, salió rico.
¿Cómo? No se va a... ¿No está caliente? Bueno, sí.
Qué ricura. Cristian.
Perfecto.
Qué rico.
Ay, no.
Vamos a ver las servilletas.
Ay, sí, señora.
Me dejo la tonta. Gracias Dios por estos alimentos. Por favor bendícelos, Padre, santifícalos para nuestro cuerpo. Te pedimos que bendigan nuestras manos, bendigan nuestro trabajo. Y por favor, Señor, provee para todos aquellos que están en necesidad. En el nombre de Jesús, amén.
Amén.
Provecho.
Provecho. A mí siempre me ha gustado aquí lo más delgadito.
Pues yo entré por aquí. ¿Qué tal?
Oh my God.
Está rico.
Yeah.
Ya me saborea.
My dad would love this. Mira, ya te hiciste taco.
Ya, ya. Para luego estar, dice un dicho.
Wow. Yo apenas aquí empezando.
Estás perdiendo el tiempo.
Literal. Muy para ello.
Córrele, córrele. Acá te quedó competir en carrera.
Ay, no. A ver, ¿qué? Oh, hace mucho que no comía esto, mami.
Pensaste que iba a traer un filetito, chicos.
¿Cómo que un filete? Te dije.
Sí, ya. Sí. Escuché tu voz. No friegues.
All right, you guys. So we had dinner. Me and mi hija, entrale. A ver, let us know if it's good. I haven't tried that one. If this is it too sweet, no vas a ver al tuyo. No, no, no me convence.
O sea, no está así que wow.
Okay. Pues qué bueno, because they're not gonna make that one again. So I was telling my mom that I got the pineapple upside down.
It's whatever.
It's whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then for myself, I got the lemon raspberry. So I'll probably have this tomorrow because it's a little too late for that. Entrale, entrale. And for Manny, I got him strawberries and cream. So
that's it. It's too much.
Let him know this is for him, and you can take yours in here too.
Yeah.
But you guys, it's like 9 something already, so.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's 9 night time.
No.
You're funny.
Muy rico.
Thank you very much for this video.
Muy bien.
Thank you.
Good night. I will see you guys on another episode of me moving, because that's what we're gonna get back to. Papi, happy birthday. The memory of when I was in the hospital with you, and the doctor had only given you 3 months to live. And there we were, 6 months later, celebrating your 60th birthday just came up. And just to see you smiling like that with all of us there and celebrating your birthday with you was so amazing. Thank you guys so much for being here and for always sharing those beautiful moments with my family. I love you guys. Bye.